or map projection. It is the process of transferring points or place of the object into the normal cylinder, the point of tangency is at the equator. But you have a transverse, which the point of tangency is at the pole. And you also have the oblique that we normally use. The point of tangency is at the equator. Now, a cartographer can transfer a sphere to a flat surface without distortion. He must project the surface of the sphere onto a plane surface. An example of this projection, that the cylinder is tangent along the equator. Now, a conic projection, the process of transferring points from the surface of the earth to a cone or series of cones. The other name for series, sometimes you should look at the question, they call it poly. So if it is a polyconic, it would be series of cones. So we have a single or simple conic projection. It has one standard parallel, so the point of tangency is just one. We have one standard parallel. But we have the Lambert conformal, which uses two. Okay? There are two parallels. When you say parallel, you are talking of the latitude. Now, in a Lambert conformal, it is used by aircraft, so we don't use it. It is used in higher latitude for polar navigation. Normally, they use it before for radio bearings, long distance. Okay, now, in a polyconic, okay, it uses series of cones. A polyconic, it is non-conformal, it is not used in navigation, but they are used in surveying purposes. Polyconic is used in surveying purposes. They are used in atlas. Okay, now, where does a polyconic projection is based on? Now, conic, is it a cylinder?
No. Cylinder.
Plane tangent. Oh, wala rin. So you have two. But poly is series. Kaya, that is series of cone. Tangent and cylinder. Delta, delta sa to. Which chart projection would be most suitable for marine surveying?
Polyconic.
Oh, that is a polyconic
surveying, marine surveying.
Azimuthal. In the azimuthal, the points on the Earth's surface are projected directly on the plane surface, direct features of that surface. Okay. In azimuthal, we have three. One is the monic. Monic projection, the points geometrically projected from the center of the earth, and that projection, if begun, it is used to for a great circle chart. Okay, it's used for great circle chart. Now, sa mnemonic projection, yung bulb nasa center ng Earth. That is the mnemonic. Then there is a flat surface. Now, a mnemonic projection would produce a mnemonic chart. This is a chart of non-mnemonic projection. So we call it the mnemonic chart. In a mnemonic chart, this is straight line. When you transfer it to a Mercator chart, it becomes a three chart. So, in a mnemonic chart, a straight line is a great circle. Whereas, in a Mercator projection, a great circle becomes a curved line. Okay? So here, you look, what would be the highest? Okay? If this is the highest, that is your vertex. Napataas niya nung ng mataas ng great circle nyo, that would be the vertex. Okay, yung straight line na yan, if you see this latitude, this becomes the vertex, or somewhere here is the vertex. Okay, that is your highest latitude, which means when you go up, when you reach the vertex, now your forces become, it goes up. Okay, now, in a mnemonic chart, this straight line becomes a curved line when you transfer it. And this would be your vertex. Okay. What is the alternative ceiling in lieu of a left and great circle to limit the latitude? Kasi here, this is your vertex, so to limit your latitude, weather permitting, if there are plenty of low pressure here, so you have to limit your latitude. And you call that the composite ceiling. In a composite ceiling, if that is your projection for your great circle, you want to limit your latitude. So a composite ceiling is a combination of great circle, parallel, and equator. Okay, to limit the latitude. Now, you have the stereographic projection. The stereographic projection, the antipode. Antipode, it is, these are two places which is directly opposite each other on the Earth. So stereographic projection is the using it for polar navigation. Sa stereographic, okay, if we have a bulb, that would be on the other side. In a mnemonic projection, a while ago, the bulb would be here, the center of the Earth. So when you say antipode, that would be on the other side there. And that this is your, this what comes out with a stereographic projection. Now, the other one, we have the orthographic projection. In the orthographic projection, the projecting lines emanating from a point at infinity. And they are perpendicular to a tangent plane. Okay. So, if this is what comes out with the orthographic, when you say infinity, okay, you know what they are saying. They are all perpendicular. So if you see this picture on the bodies, A is for mnemonic, B is for stereographic, and C is for orthographic projection. Okay?